Hi, lovely people. I'm gonna do some new and old and makeup stuff. Put everything on my face and see what happens. Enjoy myself. All is in there. High end, not high end, everything. So we're just gonna have some fun with makeup and play around with it. As an eyeshadow palette, I'm gonna use the Jeffree Star cremated palette because, yeah, we're real. I bought it. I wanna try it, I wanna play with it. I know it's a lot of controversy around Jeffree Star at the moment, but to be really honest, I bought this. It's expensive. I want to use it, so I'm going to use it on my channel. I don't know if we're going to buy new stuff or not. I don't like the lip liners, so I'm not buying any of those, but we'll see. I'm just here for makeup, not for drama, not for anything else. So we're just going to play with all of it and enjoy ourselves, and we'll see what happens. I'm going to start with putting on my primer. This is from Rose Gold, one of my favorites. This is Hydro Glow Cream, and this is from, what's this company called? Vita Masks LTD, just VQBeauty.com comes from. And I got this in a beauty box, which in the Netherlands is called a Styletone box. And I quite like this, to be really honest. It's almost gone. Will I buy it again? No, it's too expensive. It's a primer. It does its job. Let's be real, it really does. But it's a primer. So I'm probably not going to buy it for myself. But it was a really nice product to get in a beauty box. And now I'm going to go in with my Makeup Revolution Soap Styler. I used this in my full face of Makeup Revolution. But I used it the wrong way around. So I want to try it again. Give it an honest thought about it. See if it works better if I use it first. So yeah, this is what it looks like on the inside. Just a little bit of soap. I'm gonna wet it. I'm using my Boosty Soap spoolie, which I got as a free gift with an order. I'm getting my spoolie in there and trying the dry and the wet because I wetted it. And just get some out, yeah. And let's see if we can do this. And you probably not see me, you're gonna see me more with this. I now have a ponytail at the moment because I had to work today, had my early shift. So 3.5 months of not working, I started working again. And even though it's a little bit risky with my face mask on, and I have a reaction to the face mask because I have really dry skin here, here, and here at the moment. But we'll see how good it covers under my foundation. So that looks quite different. Let's see if it stays put. I'll let it dry and I'll be right back with you. Well, it feels quite dry and quite stiff. I'm gonna try my Gino & Co. Blender. This is the fussy one. Feels really soft. I used it once or twice, but I'm still not really sure about it, so let's try it again. And I'm going to use today the Morphe foundation. This is a Fluidity Full Coverage foundation. And I have F220. And this is matte foundation. I have used it once or twice, but I wanted to use it on camera and see what I think of it. And yeah, maybe shouldn't have done it with a new sponge as well. But yeah, I want to try these things. I just want to try some new bits on here and see what you guys think of it. And if you like it, if you enjoy it, tell me, let me know. And yeah, I just want to go. This is what I'm gonna put on my face today. And I think I'm quite good with the color, matching to myself. But we'll see how it comes out. Yeah, I guess just plak eraan. Oeh, dat is veel coverage hoor. Okay. I used the sponge once before. I don't know what for which foundation, but this foundation doesn't seem to cling in there. And the other one did. It seems to be keeping everything on my face. That makes it really nice coverage. So I don't know, okay, if you can see at the end the dryness I have from wearing a face mask all day. Okay, that's covered quite nice. And if you can see, but also like again, I have here the dryness and here you can see the stripes on it. But I'm only gonna put a little bit more of my foundation on my nose. And I'm using my BH Studio Pro 8 brush, BH Cosmetics from BH Cosmetics. I'm just gonna do it on my nose. A little bit here. That's it. I don't think I need more. Like you can see, the foundation oxidizes a little bit. That's why it's a perfect. I always choose light, medium, and neutral, which I think is a good match for me. I'm going in with a new, completely new concealer to me. This is from a again from my beauty box, the Stratum box. This, if I'm pronouncing this right, a Paesa Brightening Concealer. And this is also vegan. And it's also vegan, cruelty-free and everything. So yeah, because the box has only vegan and cruelty-free stuff in there, which I quite like. Not that I worry about it, to be really honest. I do use stuff that's not vegan or cruelty-free, but... it is good that the box gives everyone an opportunity to get makeup, which is nice. So I'm just going to try this for the first time. Never tried this before. Let's put this there. Over there. Yeah. Let's just try it there and see what happens. New. I wanted. I always like the brightening, so and it does that. So quite like that. Quite good coverage. I honestly didn't check on the concealer what it has, what it says it did. Because it's on the box and I always throw away the boxes. I can't check that. Yeah, the soap brows are staying better in place with this this way of doing it first, which would be logical, but good to know. Now quite stick to my skin. Looks really flat. It's really, really stiff. Yeah. And for my newest powder, I'm gonna go again with the Exit Revolution powder and Translucent. This is a loose powder. It was quite, it is quite smelly and everything, like I said before, but it did work, so we're gonna use it. It's very, very fine, this powder. Now I'm going in with my Silk Touch Baked Powder in Dore number 204. This is from Bisoda Milano. This is not new in. I've got this for a while. But I've recently used it again for my face. And it's actually quite, works quite good. I've noticed with loose powders that it dries more on my skin. And this is a baked powder, is what it looks like. Like you can see, it's quite flat, quite used already. Quite liked it. And I'm just gonna with this on the rest of my face to set everything in place. So a little bit of faves in here as well. And just a little bit of new in stuff. Just playing around with makeup, doing nothing in. Don't using a brand in particular. And of course hoping that everyone enjoys this song. That's the powder on. I'm going in with my Prep and Prime from Primark. This is the MAC dupe and this smells delicious. I've tried it. I've sprayed it once, not used it on my face yet, so. Ooh, nice. Yeah, smells good. Yeah, yes, go in with my Boozy Shop contour brush, which I should actually clean, but oh well. Oh, this is, ooh. I did not tell you which contour I used already. This is one of my newest contour palettes. I was this or the Roxaris from Makeup Revolution contour and highlight palette, but I think this was the last. I'm not sure. Could be the other one. Anyways, this is Elf contour palette and this light medium. And this is one of my faves. My ultimate fave is the Essence Duo palette contouring palette. But then I'm going in with bronzer, and again I'm using. I'm using Exit Revolution. This is the Chaos Bronzer. This is my newest in bronzer I've got. This is what it looks like on the inside. And I have a new brush I want to try. This is my Creative Cosmetic brush number 4. This is an angled brush. And I want to try this. I got this again in my Stelton Beauty Box. So, yeah, I'm going to... Ooh. Okay, there's a lot of products on there already. Be careful, okay. This brush is more dense than what you normally use. This looks really dark on my camera, but it doesn't look in front of me in a mirror that's dark. It just looks like that on the camera. So. I'm gonna continue what I'm doing. Of course, my hairline. But it doesn't look as blended on. The camera. Oh well. We'll see. We'll wait for the end result. But it really looks really, really good like this in natural, in the normal light. Just the camera makes it really pop. Oh, my hair got loose. Put it back in. Promise you my hair will look fine at the end. It just doesn't look like now. Yeah, it looks really good on the mirror. And if I look now, you see. Looks not as good. But I'm gonna continue. Brush is nice, different than I would use before, but I have a feeling it got it better in there in my skin. Looks quite really, really nicely blended in my mirror. I hope it doesn't look as bad as camera. But it looks worse in my camera as it does in my mirror. We'll see. I'm going with blush. Again, XX Revolution, the last blush I've got. This is the color Jitter. It's a little bit of a, what do you call it, corally shade, I think. It is. I'm going in with my Kiko number 10 brush, which is my blush brush, which I always use. I do like to get a couple more of face brushes, but I don't know which one to get yet. So if you have any tips on brushes, nice brushes, let me know. Oh, ah, shedding. It's the first hair it shed since I bought it. So. But I have it 3-4 years now, I think. Good stuff. Now, my highlighter. I don't think I've used this highlighter on camera yet, but I'm not 100% sure. This is my Jaclyn Hill highlighter in the color Amped. This is the loose highlighter. I've got it on, bought this on sale with on a Morphe website where it was on sale. I'm going in with my Morphe M501 brush. I'm just gonna... Ooh, look at that, gorgeous. Perfection. Yeah, I really love this loose highlighter, even though you have to be really careful. I don't think I will, will ever pan this one, because it's really... You don't, because you don't need not more much. So yeah, tip of my nose. Wow, look at that. And my lips. Gorgeous. Yeah, I love this highlighter. It's really, really good. Jaclyn all done herself, let's be real. Going in with a little bit more of my setting spray. To be honest, with all my skin dryness, it looks quite decent, it looks okay. Quite like it, love it. Hope you like it too. I've used just makeup I love and some new bits. And the most important thing in life is enjoy yourself. Please always enjoy yourself, no matter what you do, no matter how you do it. Enjoy yourself. And now we're going in with the most controversial products in this tutorial, the Cremated palette, because I want to try it again and I want to do it on camera. Yeah, if you don't like it, just don't watch it. What I love about this palette is that you can just clap it. I quite like it. I don't have any other palette in this kind of range. So yeah, I quite like it. I enjoy it. So. I enjoy it and I want to play with it. That's the truth. No tea, no nothing, it's just the truth. Now I want to try something a little bit different. And I'm gonna try an eye look with the from Amy the Duchess. Does this at the moment a lot on Instagram, so the idea comes from her, but I'm using my own spin on it. This is my Morphe small pencil brush, and I'm gonna use the color Hirsch, which is a black from the palette. I'm gonna go in with the black and just create the shapes I want. I hope it works, because yeah, trying something new is not all the smartest thing to do on camera, but yeah, I like doing that. Let's copy this on your eye. It's just the beginning. I'm gonna paint this all in, but I just wanna. Okay, it followed. It's not as easy to flick away as I thought. Now I'm gonna get my M507 and just paint in this corner. I think I'm gonna paint in this corner. I just think it's easier to do with a little bit bigger brush. Hope I can fine-tune the lines a little bit. And make it quite black. I'm going to go in with RIP. This one. And I'm going to use another M507 to do this. So I'm going in with RIP. And I'm just gonna blend out the black. See if I'm going okay. I hope that what I have in my eyes, I hope that what I have in my head is gonna work on my eyes, but we'll see. Not blending as good as I hoped it would, but I'll just keep on blending. I'm gonna use a different mirror. This one's too big. Yeah, I think you can see it better like this. Yep. I want not to see the black line anymore, so I'm gonna blend this out. More. Yeah, just a little bit. Okay. Yep. That looks shite at the moment. No, it's not. It's okay. It's just different. Because I wanted to try something new, which I haven't done before for you all. I'm going in with my Morphe M506. I'm going to go in with Life Insurance, which is this one. The one with a car on it. With a funeral car, I think. No, it's not the same as hers. It's nurse, is a... I don't know. So we're going to use that to blend out again. Because it isn't the car that your coffin will be into. Is that not called a hearse? Because why would you put a hearse at life insurance but not a hearse car in the hearse color? And I thought about not using this palette anymore on my channel, but I figured it's new. I bought it. Too late to return it to the company I'll use it. I'll enjoy it. I play with it. It's not as sharp anymore, but I don't know if you can see the line. It's still separated. That's the plan. Well, that's my plan at least. Let's blend out here. Now, in the inner corner, I'm gonna put diamond ashes because it's gorgeous. And I'm gonna use my Jessup 237 detailed shader. And that's one of the things I hate about Jeffree Star, the fact that he's completely controversial, completely doing wrong things, making wrong decisions. But you see, look at this. How incredible is this? Such a shame that it comes from such an annoying person. I mean, his makeup is amazing, at least in my eyes. I love my Jeffree Star palettes. And to be honest, I hate the fact that I can't use it anymore or anything, so I'm just using it. Because I think it's a waste not to do anything with it. It's cost me too much money not to use it. I get why it's controversial, I really get it. But it's just so pretty. It just is so gorgeous. Now I'm going in with my Morphe and Jeffree Star GS13 with the color Goodbye, which is this one, which is a metallic. And I'm gonna blend the diamond ashes now into the gray with this metallic. To make it all mesh and mesh together. I quite like this. Completely different from whatever else I've tried before, but yeah. Let's just first do my lower lash line. First, gonna go in with my Maybelline Lasting Drama Gel Automatic Gel Pencil in black. Now I'm gonna go in with my 226 Smudger Brush from Jessup. Going in with just a little bit black. Clean it on my color swatch. I'm going to straighten in with Life Insurance, with this one with, I think, the hearse in it, right? I'm going in with my GS6 and I'm going to put diamond ashes on my brow bone, or in my brows at the moment. And I must say, this time the soap styler sticks better than the first time I tried it. But we go in my inner corner a little bit more. I'm gonna fill in my eyebrows with my Catrice Lumetic Ultra Precise, because not because it's the last one I bought, but because I I think this one is amazing. And I'm gonna just put in a little bit more. Here's, and this more I'm not gonna do, just a little bit more. Here's, yep, that's better. At least I think that's better. This is from Douche Punk Volumizing Mascara. I'm going in with my newest pair. This is from Primark PS. This is a 3 euro lashes. This is a 3D Angel. Let's try my lashes. Now we're gonna go in with my Charlotte Tilbury lip tryout thingy. And I wanna try the red carpet red. And I'm nosy as how this works. Okay. You can just pull this off. A little bit of lipstick in it. I'm using my Morphe & Jeffree Star GS14. I first wanted to try the typical Pillow Talk, but yeah, I didn't want another nude. I want a bright red with this girl black look. That was fun to try out. Nice color, by the way. Yeah, well, the brows don't last that long because they let it go already. I'm gonna put some gems. I'm gonna get gems. Should I do some? That's everything on. I'm gonna do my hair and I'll be right back. Yeah, lovely people. That's all of it on. Wow, came out quite amazing to me. I think so, at least. I hope you liked it too. Yeah, like you can see now, with all floating in my skin. It's not too much, just perfect. I like the red lip. I've seen when I did my gems, it's not kiss proof. But yeah, I love it. It was a lot of fun. Came out way more different than I thought. Do you like the gems on it? I quite like it. I love this. I hope you enjoy it. I hope you will come back to me again. And yeah.